I am Dr. Kaushik De, Assistant Professor in the Department of Physics, SBSS Mahavidyalaya, West Bengal. Hello student. In this session, we are going to learn about something that we have seen throughout the course of our life. Some things which we see a lot, but we understand only a little about. It is what? That separate day from the night, it comes in many colors. But it collectively white. It is also responsible for the joy of our sight. So what it is? It is the light. Beauty of nature, colorful world are the phenomena of light. There is a great role of light in photosynthesis process also. But understanding what the light is and what it does is a challenging work. Therefore, we have to look beyond what we see. So, let's learn about the light. There are two types of light sources, like the sun, the moon, the lightning, and certain type of insect, fishes are all example of natural source of light. While a candle flame, lamps, and light fixture are the artificial source of light. The work of Newton, Heisenberg on the light in 17th century help us to understand the some phenomena of light. Newton's theory can explain the geometric optics, but it cannot explain the interference, diffraction and the polarization of the light. But whereas the Heisenberg principle, Heisenberg theory can explain the interference and diffraction of light, but it still cannot explain the polarization of the light. Therefore, a more sophisticated description of light was developed by Maxwell in 19th century. This theory depicts light as a transverse wave composed of oscillating electric and magnetic field which are right angle to each other into perpendicular to the direction that the wave moves. And which can explain the interference, diffraction, and the polarization of the light. So, the light is a transverse electromagnetic radiation. Electromagnetic radiation is a large family, consists of seven members, the whole region known as the electromagnetic spectrum. One particular family member which lies in the middle of the spectrum, which our eyes can detect, is called the visible of light. Now, the other types of electromagnetic radiation are also light, but not visible to our eyes. Similarly, this radiation, although part of the same family of light, are slightly different from one to another. This difference is due to the three factors. These three factors are wavelength, frequency, and energy. These three factors are different for each member of the electromagnetic spectrum. Different frequencies produces the different kinds of light. For the visible light, the different frequency will correspond to the different color. Frequency, or is frequency greater than the visible light, are known as the UV radiation, X-ray, and gamma rays. And frequency less than the visible light, known as the infrared radiation, microwaves, and the radio waves. The different waves have the different purpose of use, like radio waves for broadcasting TV and radio signal, and microwave used in telecommunication like mobile network, Bluetooth, and wireless LAN. Whereas the infrared using for electric stove for heating and cooking foods. Next, we have the visible light region, which makes the world visible to us. Radio waves to visible light are very low energy radiation, which are safe after even a prolonged use. Ultraviolet radiation used in medical industry and water purification. And the X-ray, which used to a great extent by medical industry to the airport security for scanning purpose.
Gamma ray are the highest energy radiation in this spectrum. It is used in medical purpose and nuclear explosion. From ultraviolet to gamma rays are referred to the high energy radiation. You should take proper precaution if you use high energy radiation for a long time. So far we have discussed how all these types of radiation is differ from one another. Despite of difference in their wavelength, frequency and energy, they all travel in the same speed. And this is the fastest known speed in the universe. So, all the students, if you have any query and question, then you can ask me. As we conclude this session, let's have a quick recap what we have learned today. We learned that light is a transverse electromagnetic wave. It shows the variation of color and energy due to their variation of frequency. Some part of light is visible to us, some are not. And speed of all spectrum is same, and that is then known as the speed of light.
Thank you.